Good morning, class. We are starting off with the very first chapter, crop production and management. Let's try to understand the definition of agriculture. The practice of growing crops and rearing animals for food, clothing, and other useful products is called agriculture. Now, what do I mean by rearing animals? Rearing animal means to take care of and to bring them up. So we are rearing animals or taking care of them or bringing them up for food, clothing, and other useful products. And the word agriculture is derived from the Latin word. Agri means a field. Cultura means cultivation. You will be surprised to know that even today, agriculture is still the major occupation of people in our country, with nearly 70% of the population engaged in this sector. Agriculture can be broadly classified into agronomy, study and development of techniques for improving agricultural practices. Now, what do I mean by this? To bring about a good yield of crop, we need to bring about an improvement in the agricultural techniques. It might be getting a good quality seed or bringing about an improvement in the quality of soil. So all these things can be achieved by employing modern techniques. And agronomy deals in that matter where it develops modern techniques to take care of the quality of seed as well as the quality of the soil so that we can get good crop yield. Horticulture. It deals with cultivation of fruits, vegetables, and ornamental plants. Now, what do I mean by ornamental plants? Ornamental plants are used for decorative purpose. They are used for display or they are grown in fields. Animal husbandry. Rearing and management of domestic animals. I've already told you what is rearing. Rearing is nothing but taking care of crops. Plants of the same kind when grown and cultivated at one place on a large scale for food, clothing and medicine, it is called a crop. Let's look at an example. For example, a crop of rice means that all the plants grown in a field are of rice. One more example could be a crop of wheat. What do I mean by this? It simply means that in particular field, the crops that are grown are of wheat. Some crop plants grown in India. Type of crop. Cereal crops are rich in carbohydrates. An example for cereal crops are rice, wheat, maize, barley, ragi. Pulses are rich source of proteins. Grams, peas, beans. All seeds, they are rich source of fat. Mustard, groundnut. Root crops are rich source of starch. Sweet potato. Sugar crops. Under these we have sugarcane and beetroot. Methods of crop production. Under this we have 7 steps. First one is preparation of soil. Second one is manuring. Third is sowing. Fourth, irrigation. Fifth, crop protection. Sixth is harvesting. And seventh is storage and distribution. Let's look into these steps one by one. Preparation of soil. It is a process by which the soil is made suitable for sowing of seeds. This involves the following steps. Now, why the soil has to be prepared? Now, when the seed germinates, the roots are produced and the roots should have proper penetration so that it can absorb water and minerals and finally give us a good yield. For that reason, we prepare the soil. So, under preparation of soil, what are the steps that are required? One is plowing or tilling. Plowing is a process of loosening and turning the soil for better percolation of water and air. Now, what do I mean by percolation? Percolation means better movement of water and air. Advantages of plowing. Loose soil allows roots to grow deep into the soil and support plants. Now look at this diagram. Here the soil particles are close to each other, and the roots of the plant are not able to penetrate because the soil particles are close to each other. Now this is a soil which has been plowed, where the soil is loose and there are a lot of gaps between the soil particles. We see that the roots of the plant are able to easily percolate, or it is easily able to move in into the soil. Plowing aerates the soil. This allows the roots to breathe easily. Now over here, look at the soil which has not been plowed. Here the air molecules are not easily able to penetrate because the soil particles are closely adhered to each other. Whereas over here, which has the soil which has been plowed, we see that the air molecules can easily penetrate and circulation of air molecules are there within the soil. This is known as aeration. Plowing also brings the nutrient-rich soil to the top so that plants can use these nutrients. Now look at this diagram as well as the arrow that has been drawn over here. The nutrient-rich soil which is below has been brought onto the top by means of plowing. Manure and fertilizers mix better with plowed soil. Loosened soil helps in the growth of earthworm and microbes present in soil, which increases the fertility of the soil. Because of the proper aeration, we see the growth of the earthworm and microbes is promoted. The last one, loose soil helps sunlight to reach deeper layers of soil and kill harmful microbes. Next, moving on to agricultural equipments that are used for plowing. First, we will start off with the plow. Here, the plow has got the presence of plow shaft. And one end of the plow shaft has beam. And this end is attached to the cattle. The other end has got the presence of plowshare. This is like a blade that is used to plow the soil. And this one is a handle which is held by the farmer. This entire plow is either made up of iron or it is made up of wood. Nowadays, instead of this particular plow, we have this plow that is being used for plowing. I have attached a video of how exactly a disc plow works. You can have a look at it. As a homework, you can make a list of the points that is mentioned in the video and go through it. Thank you.